Alright, hello everybody, welcome. This is Rocky Mike, coach of the Virginia Victinis, and this is our official team reveal for the new league that we are joining called Mythical Mayhem from the Game Room, TGR. So yeah, very exciting. Like I said, I'm gonna do a quick team reveal, why we drafted it. If you are not super interested, that's fine. I'm putting a timestamp on the description, so you can skip directly to the week one battle. Since we already battled, and yeah, I'm just trying it there. Anyway, this is not your standard league, although we are joining several standard leagues. But this is not your standard league. This is called the Mythical Mayhem for a reason. This is actually a league that allows all Pokemon, including mythicals and restricted legendaries, and it is also a BGC league, not necessarily a 6v6, but a Bring 6 Big 4 Best of 3 league. So yeah, very excited. This is the highest power league on the Game Room. They have a lot of different types of leagues. This one is the one that allows everything, even more so than Ubers, because if you think about it, Ubers usually, you know, you have one legendary at a time in the field, but this one can have two. Anyway, fun stuff is fun. I just like, if you know me, you know that I like playing with broken stuff, so I just wanted to play with some broken stuff, and therefore we are joining this season, which is great. Thank you for having me, and without any further ado, we can go ahead and get this started. But before I start showing you who I have, I'm gonna say that this league had a lot of coaches. I'm not entirely sure how many it is. There's a lot of them. I was lucky enough to get pick number 5, so that's not the best, but it is also not the worst. So I knew that I was gonna get something decent for my first pick at least, the very least, right? So anyway, yeah, my first pick is good old, what you call it? There we go, good old Coraidon. Yeah, I don't know how much I need to say about Coraidon. He is one of the best Pokemon in the game currently. The Scarlet Mythical the Scarlet Mascot Legend that sets up Sun when it comes in. I don't remember the name of his ability, but yeah, he sets up Sun as soon as it comes in, which I think is great to be able to build around a team for doubles, since, you know, you can pick things that synergize with it, I guess. Yeah, there's not much to say about this. It gives me Sun, it gives me a lot of offense. The Dragon fighting typing is fantastic, although it doesn't enjoy fairies, but it does get coverage for them, mainly on the form of Heavy Slam, which, given how heavy this thing is usually very high power. But yeah, I ended up picking this up because right before me, let me see, Calyrex Shadow went. I believe Kyurem Black, Chiyu, Miraidon, and funnily enough, Malamar, right before me. So yeah, I was able to pick this up, thank goodness! They didn't let me pick what you call Miraidon, because I would have had to play my copy of Scarlet, my copy of Violet to its entirety, and I don't have time for that right now. So anyway, yeah, we're taking my Mascot Legendary, and that is fantastic. Anyway, for my second pick, I wanted to pick something that would synergize with this Pokemon, and if Coraidon and Miraidon are not the best Pokemon in the game, then you can very much make an argument that my next pick is Flormane. If you know Flormane, then you know how broken this thing is. Not so much in doubles as it is in singles, obviously, but even in doubles, it is a force to be reckoned with. You know, it shows up. This Pokemon is just dominant in any format that is allowed. Part of the reasons why it's so broken. But yeah, I'm surprised that I managed to get this in the second round, mostly because this league has four Sun teams, not just one. Because there's a team that has Groudon, there's a team that has Ninetales, and I believe there might be a team that has Torkoal, I'm not sure. But I think there's like at least three or four something. So I was very surprised that I was able to grab this when it came back to my pick, because there were a lot of teams in between my two picks. But anyway, you know, Protosynthesis increases my highest attack. My highest stat usually is going to be a special attack or speed. You know, we can tailor it to whatever it is. Fantastic speed tier in 135. Fantastic special attack in 135. It gets good moves. Dazzling Gleam is a staff move that hits both targets, which is great. Molten Blast is just one single target and hits really hard. It gets stuff like Taunt, it gets Trick Room, it gets Imprisoned to deal with that as well if I don't really want to deal with Trick Room. And I guess Mental Eruption Shenanigans, it gets Pain Split. This Pokemon, it gets a stupid amount of coverage like Mystical Fire and Thunderbolt. And this Pokemon is just broken. This Pokemon is broken, it's always going to be broken. And yeah, very happy to have it again. We have played with it on PML before, but that was singles league. Excited to try it on doubles. So yeah, for my pick number three, I figure that the restrictions were starting to go, so I figured that I needed to grab my second restricted. There were still a few good amount of options. I cannot tell you why I picked what I picked, but I can tell you that I am very happy with my pick, and that is going to be good old Lugia. Yes, we managed to get Lugia, which is not, if I understand correctly, it is not as scary in doubles as it is in singles, just because, you know, it's a faster pace, and this Pokemon is more of a wall or a setup Pokemon, which I understand, it makes sense, but at the same time, you have to understand, you know, this Pokemon is pretty much locked into heavy-duty boots whenever you play in Uber singles. In this format, you really aren't, mostly because there's hazards are basically non-existent. So this Pokemon is able to run other items, like leftovers, which is super annoying, or you can run, I don't know, some safety goggles to don't be put asleep ever by Spore. You can run Weakness Policy, you can run Life Orb. Multiscale is a fantastic ability, if Dragonite has ever shown. And this Pokemon has a pretty good coverage, right? It gets both its stabs in Psyshock, Psychic, it gets Aeroblast, it gets Hurricane, it gets Air Slash. It even gets stuff for, it even gets coverage for ground typing, Air Power. My only complaint is that it doesn't get Storm Power for some reason. But you know, that's not the biggest complaint, I guess. If that's the biggest complaint, then that tells you how broken this Pokemon is. So yeah, that's all I'm gonna say about this. Oh, it also gets Tailwind, I believe, which is great. I'm not probably never gonna use it for Tailwind just because of how powerful it is, but you know, the option is there and that's good. And yeah, that's all I can say about Lugia. I should note that the reason why I have, I guess, the Shadow Lugia from Pokemon XD here is because on this league I decided I'm going to be using my Pokemon XD Lugia. Yeah, we're bringing it up from the Gen 3 games, since Pokemon Home is gonna be going out of service pretty soon. So yeah, we will get to use it. And yeah, fun stuff. Game Freak, please bring this model into the game, and that's all I can say. Anyway, moving on to the four Pokemon, as I mentioned, I'm not going to be using this Pokemon as, or I don't want to be using this Pokemon as Tailwind, because it's just so strong, one of my best Pokemon on the team, so I wanted to grab something that will give me some sort of speed control. And the best thing available on the board, even though it was a little bit expensive for what it is, just to give you a reference, Lugia is 13 points and the next Pokemon is 12 points, which that should tell you how expensive it is, but we decided to go ahead and grab good old Mokro. And if you're playing during the first regulation, I guess it's regulations A or regulations 1 of the Gen 9 BGC format, you know how annoying this Pokemon it is, because during that time, this was the only team that had Prankster and had Tailwind. So it was very dominant. It wasn't part of almost every top team. And yeah, well, you know, you give this thing an Aviola or a Focus Sash, and you can definitely ensure that it's going to be around for a few turns. It has other utility moves as well, like Pond, it gets Squash. Brave Bears for this team are not, you know, super weak either, just because Brave Bear is step and it is such a high power move. And it gives me also Prankster Sunny Day, which is great because I figured that one of the strategies my opponents are going to try to do to counteract my team is going to be trying to remove the sun, since so much of my team is kind of revolved around the sun. Lugia's not, which is why I picked up Lugia, I guess. because I don't want to be too reliant on the sun. So yeah, this Pokemon is great. It also gives priority to haste in case it's ever needed. So yeah, it's just a toolbox that allows me to do many different things, which is great. I have played a restricted league in the past without a tailwind option, and it just, let's just say, it didn't go great. So yeah, I'm glad I was able to pick this up on round 4. Like I said, a little bit expensive, but I think that, you know, it's gonna prove its value during the season. We'll see. Maybe I'm just imagining it. Maybe I'm just, you know, hoping, but we'll see. Anyway, pick number 5. Try to start building around Sun again. So actually, I got a snipe. Well, I got a snipe a few turns before he got back to my turn. So this was my secondary option. Now it works with Sun, however, it's not the Pokemon that I wanted. I wanted some sort of redirection, because I have Lugia as a setup mon for the most part. I have Coridon who can source them. So redirection, if you play on doubles, is very important. It's not, you know, indispensable, but it is important. It is strong. It is useful. So I wanted a Mongoose. Unfortunately, it got a snipe a few turns before it came back to my turn, which is unfortunate, and also a little bit weird, because the Pokemon I picked up next, it's actually on the board. It was actually value more than a Mongoose. It was actually value as 10 points, while a Mongoose was value at 9 points. And I firmly believe that a Mongoose is better. I could be looking at it from the perspective of on my team, a Mongoose will be better, perhaps just because of the resistances and typing and whatnot. But anyway, without any further ado, the next Pokemon that we pick up was Ribbonet. At the end of the day, this is just platform of a Mongoose without the poison typing and without Regenerator. But Protosynthesis, like I said, is not a useless ability given that we do have Sun. So, you know, it's always going to get a boost in its either attack or, you know, more either defense or special defense. I haven't played much with this Pokemon to be able to tell you. I know that it can never boost its speed. Because Game Freak designed this Pokemon to never be able to boost its speed. Fun fact, if you make this Pokemon timid with 0 EVs on attack, it will still be 1 point higher on attack than in speed. So, good job Game Freak on balancing this Pokemon, because they definitely don't want a fast Spore user. But on that note, this Pokemon gets Spore, this Pokemon gets Rage Powder, which is Redirection, as I mentioned, this Pokemon gets Sucker Punch, which is great, it gets, you know, natural stuff like Dark Moves, and Crunch, and Sip Bomb and whatnot, a Solar Blade on the Sun, which hits really hard. It also gets Close Combat for coverage, which is great, it can hit other Dark types really hard, and even Steel types. So, yeah, pretty good Pokemon. I expect to do well, not as well as a Mongoose would have done, but, you know, you take what you can get, right? So yeah, moving on, for our fifth Pokemon, I guess a few snipes had happened at this point, and I just didn't know what I wanted to pick up, so I ended up grabbing something that I think is cheeky, and it was a little bit undervalued, so I ended up grabbing Cyclizar, good old Accelerate. It was only 5 points, which I think is pretty cheap, because in this league, he can use Shadtail. Yes, Shadtail and doubles is not nearly as good as it is on singles, but Shadtail at the end of the day is Shadtail. Giving a face to the Lugia or to Groudon, or even Flutterman for that matter, I think will be great. This Pokemon also gets a lot of, I guess, niche options. In Knockoff, Taunt, it gets Endeavor for low health. It has decent attack stat and special attack stat if I went wrong with it, one of them. So yeah, it's not super great, so I understand putting it on 5, but at the end of the day, Shadtail, right? So that's the only reason why we grab it. I think it was a good value pick, and you know, my budget was starting to run out. Unfortunately, this league only gives you like, I don't know, 87 points, 97 points, which is a weird number, but it is what it is. So yeah, Cyclizar, we did great on the BSS league that we joined at the very beginning of the generation, when I guess the longer timer wasn't an option. We took the championship with it, so never underestimate this thing, especially Shadtail, right? But anyway, moving on. For our next pick, again, I was just looking at options. something cheeky that I saw that I guess will be good was this Stonejourner. I'm excited to be drafting this Pokemon because I will never draft this on singles, so I would like to use every Pokemon at least once. This Pokemon is definitely, it has more potential. I don't know if I say it's better, but it has more potential on doubles. You know, it's just a rock type, somewhat fast. I mean, it's base 70, but things don't run so fast sometimes on BGC. You value bulk sometimes more than just the speed. You know, rock slide is rock slide, and I have that one, right? But rock slide, you know, I can always flinch stuff. It gets white guard, which is a lot less distributed this generation, I think. It's the only thing on my team that gets white guard. But you know, it will be helpful against, you know, things that will log into spray moves, like, for example, a Terastallize Terrapagos with her Sandstorm, right? Starstorm. It wouldn't be able to go through Wygarde, which is fantastic. It just puts some restriction, and it makes my opponents have to think a little bit more when team building than just slapping, you know, a bunch of spread moves in their team just to come into the game and get completely walled by this thing. But the main reason why I drafted this is because it's an ability power spot, which gives a 1.3 boost to its ally Pokemon's, all of their moves, not just special attacks or physical attacks, all of the moves. So this thing is basically a life orb with feet for the Pokemon that is on the side. So, you know, if I get a choice picks, Florimane sitting right next to this, Florimane won't be hitting with 1.5. Boost on its attack, it will be hitting with 1.8, which is scary when you think about it. So that's almost like activity. So yeah, this Pokemon was 7 points. I think it's good value. We'll see how many times we bring it during the week, during the 8-week season. But yeah, no, I'm decently satisfied with it. So we'll see. I think it has potential. So anyway, next pick, a more standard Sun pick, I guess, in Executor. I mean, we're drafting Sun. You should draft at least one Chlorophyll user, right? And Venusaur either was drafted before me, or I was gonna pay for how many points that thing is worth. It's the best Chlorophyll user, obviously, but you know, the budget doesn't allow for it. I was looking at other options. Shiftry. Originally, I was pretty sure I was gonna draft Shiftry, but having to grab the Brubunet ended up making that not necessarily the best option. And also, it's more expensive than this. And I had to draft a Pokemon. I had the thought that I didn't need to draft a Pokemon, but you had to draft a Pokemon. So yeah, there was not enough space on the budget. At least not if I wanted to draft all my Pokemon to be useful, right? Because I could just draft a Pokemon and then draft 2 1-pointers at the end, but I don't think that is fun because I'm not gonna bring the 1-pointers. So yeah, if you know me, you will know that a successful season for me is a season where you bring all your Pokemon at least once to every game. So yeah, Executor. I think this Pokemon is interesting because it is powerful. It has a pretty decent special attack stat of 125, I believe, or something like that. But it is also like a two-way street, if that makes sense, because I was running on Calyx, and this thing in the sun with timid nature and max speed is actually faster than your standard max speed Calyrex Shadow, which is the fastest Pokemon in the format to worry about. I mean, Regieleki will be faster, but I'm not gonna worry about Regieleki. There's very few things that outspeed it. But this thing outspeeds Calyrex Shadow, which is great. We can put it to sleep, or we can just attack it. But also, given with the 55 base speed, this Pokemon has an option for Trick Room because it is pretty slow, and it also gets access to Trick Room. So yeah, I think that is a very interesting angle to look at it, right? You can, if when you're preparing to this Pokemon, you have to think of it as a Sun Sweeper, but also as a Trick Room Sweeper. Which I do have some slow Pokemon on the team, so I like to have the option. Trick Room is much stronger in doubles, so you know, it's always good to have the option, or to have options to be able to fight it. If you draft a team that is nothing but fast Pokemon, somebody restrain room, you're gonna be in trouble. So yeah, Executor. Never used it before. in a league, either doubles or singles. So very excited to be trying it out on this league. We'll see how it does. So I had to pick two more Pokemon. Still going with the Trick Room's idea, I guess. I would like to have something that functions well in Trick Room if I ever had to use it, and you know, I have Sun. Also, I don't want people to start ringing, you know, just spread these charges versus me or something like that. So we dropped the Camerupt. It's pretty cheap. It's not the best Pokemon in the world, obviously. The 4x weakness to Water sucks, but you know, we had Sun, so that helps with that a little bit. But it also, you know, it has other traits, right? It's a ground type, so no spread electric attacks moves on me. At least, hopefully, you know. It gets doubles. It's double staff and fire and ground is pretty good. It helps with coverage for sure. It resists fairy, so you know that helps with that. But the main thing where I drafted this over other things that I could have drafted or I considered drafting. It's eruption. This thing is one of the few things that gets access to eruption. And a Trick Room is super slow, that means it's a super fast eruption. So yeah, I mean, it's a low tier Pokemon, it's not a good Pokemon, not a great Pokemon, not even a good Pokemon. But, you know, it has potential. I wish this was Mega Camerupt, but it's not. But, you know, for 4 points, I think that is a very decent option. So, pick it up, we'll see how many times that comes during the season. And I only had 2 points for my last pick. I actually knew I was going to pick this up before I knew that I was going to pick up Exeggutor and Camerupt. Like I said, I don't want any of my Pokemon to be useless. And unfortunately, I don't know, man. If I'm going to be drafting, like, I don't know, a Krikitune, that's going to be useless. I'm never going to use it. So that's a waste. So I took a look at 2-pointers. I saw something that caught my attention. So I decided I was going to go with it, and that is good old Repinch. That's right, we're grabbing the little ant because it's cute, but it's also tricky because it does have Arena Trap, so that means that there is no switching out whenever this thing is on the field. With an Nebula, you can make it somewhat bulky to at least take one or two hits. You know, it's a ground type, so electric type moves don't do anything to it. Doesn't care about Rock Slide or the flinching maybe, but it also gets access to a few niche options such as, you know, a strong Earthquake, because if, in case you didn't know, which you probably do, but in case you didn't know, this thing has 100 base attack, which is the same as Flygon. The little thing is very strong. It's frail, but it's very strong. So yeah, that's great. It also gets access to First Impression, which is always good. Priority, strong priority at that. Like I said, I want all my Pokemon to be useful in some way, and I can't see myself bringing this to a good matchup. So yeah, we're grabbing Trapinch, and that's it. So that's it. This is officially the Virginia Bikinis roster for the Mythical Mayhem season, whatever. I don't know what season it is. I apologize about that. I think this is a good team, but mostly a fun team, and that's what we're here for, right? We're just trying to have fun with some broken stuff. If you watch this, thank you for watching. We'll be, like I said, I'm putting the both this and the week one battle together on this video, so you know, if you stick around, you know, we're just gonna go to the battle now. Thank you for watching, and yeah, we'll see you in a little bit. Peace out. Hello everybody, this is Rocky Mike, coach of the Virginia Bikinis, and we are here for our week one battle versus our good friend Pokibaldi. And this is interesting. He brought Chargeabog. Okay. He didn't bring freaking Terrapagos? Are you serious? What is going on here? Holy cow. Okay. Well, I'm not sure what I want to do here. The Arcanine is poison versus Scuda, fire, okay. Still getting his water. That's annoying. All right then. I guess we're doing this. They have a bunch of stuff. What do I want to start with? Given what they got, I believe I want to start with Fluttermane and Murkrow. Right? Do I? Yeah, let's start with Fluttermane, Murkrow. We'll keep Ribbonette on the back and Crydon and see what happens. This is game one of best of three. So good luck, have fun to Baldi. And here we go. This should be a fun game. I am not nearly as good as in double battles, but I am decent. And Baldi is also pretty new too. Man, this man is just gonna go straight for the yeah, this man is going straight for the thing, right? Okay. So I can go ahead and protect, and then we could let's charge up, I guess, Electro Ball or Electro Web, whatever it's called. One showdown. We got 39 seconds. Elder, Avogon, Charge a Buck, Electro Web. Oh yeah, that's annoying. We're just gonna go ahead and that's in Gleam, and Sunny Day, I guess. Yeah, we're gonna do that. I don't know what's gonna happen, but we'll see how this goes. Man, he just straight up brought the battery kind of stuff, huh? Alright, we'll see if we can get a two-shot on those Pokemon. Oh my god! As expected, oh my god, he straight up one-shot us with the Hyper Voice, huh? Okay, that is bad. Sylveon, Jesus Christ! Screenshot. Ah, that is bad. That is not a real attack, bro, right? It's a... Yeah. Okay. Alright, I should have gone for the Tailwind. That was a mistake. So I can bring this and just die to a thing, or I can go into this and... Alright, we're gonna have to... just try and see, I guess. Our Fluttermane is not, well, what we're gonna do is we're gonna protect both of our Pokemon and see what happens. The string shot is pretty bad. Very good brains for him. String shot, lower two speed. Yeah, my Fluttermane is definitely going slower than that single thing now. And he has gotten the battery boost too, so that's not good either. I could have just tried to attack, but I don't think there's a point. Alright, they are deciding what they want to do. They can go Arcanine here. That'll be interesting. I will assume they have a Urshifu and Arcanine on the back. I need to get rid of the floor of the Sylveon as soon as possible, realistically. Let me see something. Alright, so he protected the Sylveon. He's just gonna go for the string shot, right? I don't know if it stops the thing though. Okay, I guess what we're gonna have to do is taunt this thing and Terra Heavy Slang into this. And if he Terra Sylveon, he Terra Sylveon. Alright, let's see what happens. Here comes the Terra Fire. Alright. Cillian's dead. Let's go! That's fantastic. It ate our Terra, but it's fantastic. No string shots for you, sir. Falls for taunt. Yeah, he can string shot. That's good. That's good. Okay. We'll see what he goes into next. If he goes Arcanine, this is gonna be hilarious because yeah. That's the Arcanine. Yeah. Yeah. Alright. Let's go into Brunette here. And do I want to just go for the attack? What do I want to do here? His Arcanine is a poison, unfortunately. Right? Let's see. Which means I wouldn't do a lot of damage to it, but realistically, he's not doing much damage to me either. So I'm going to go for Collision Course on the Arcanine and try to go into the Brood Brunette so I can recover my speed with Flutterman. And here comes Pokepaldi! I regret not having Sucker Punch. Alright, so he didn't Terra, which means this is going to hurt. Yeah, it's above half. Rocky Helmet, that is annoying. He's gonna Snarl, that does nothing. Yeah. Rocky Helmet is annoying. And Struggle Bot, I mean, I guess it hurts the Among Us, but that is fine. Yep. Okay. That Rocky Helmet is annoying. That Rocky Helmet is really annoying. Do I care that he kills Baldi? Pokeballdi here? No, I really don't, right? So I'm gonna go ahead and explore you and Collision Course into this. He's not gonna Terra the Arcanine. That's good for me. Alright, there goes the Arcanine. I had to take the hit from the Rocky Helmet, but that's fine. Collision Course is a monster move, man. And the sport just takes care of the annoying thingy. So yeah, okay. So Sappy is asleep. Unfortunately, our sun goes down. That's not the end of the world. He is no longer taunted, which is good for them. And here comes your Urshifu. Okay, I'm gonna need to call this real quick. Apologies. Coridon. Rhydon versus Urshifu. Oh shit. Urshifu. If you are that. Right, Collision Call destroys you, but if you Terra Poison. I'm actually not doing a whole lot to you. Which is actually not good at all. So what I'm going to do is I'm gonna go Fluttermane in here, and I'm going to I'm gonna Collision Course into this thing just to try to kill it, and yeah, the end game here is gonna be super annoying. He didn't Terra the Urshifu, the set on this man. Holy cow. Alright, well, my Coridon is dead. Wow. I can't believe he didn't Terra the Urshifu. I just can't believe he didn't Terra the Urshifu. That is crazy. That is crazy. And this thing wakes up too. It doesn't do anything, thank goodness, but... Oh! Must be nice. Okay. So I need to shot that Urshifu with the thing, otherwise I am so dead. So we're gonna go ahead and Shadow Ball you. and we're gonna go ahead and rage powder and see what happens. Holy cow, I can't believe he didn't tear the Urshifu. He must not know that what my last move is. Yeah, that is annoying. That is so annoying. Yeah, he sees the powder, which is annoying. He sees the Shadow Ball. Yeah. Here comes the Pounce. He doesn't kill me, thank goodness. But that reduces my speed. At the end of the day, that's not the worst. I do have to Shadow Ball you. And if he goes for the kill, he kills this. Let's see if this works out. He's there, poison. Alright, let's see what happens. This is such a rough game. He's playing very well. We know that he's not choice one Urshifu at least. Oh, he's faster than me. Okay, GG's. Wow, he got me. He absolutely got me. This battery crap. Yeah, absolutely completely messing me up. But that is fine. That is fine. Chargeabog, man, the low tier hero. Good job, Aldi, good job. You will be in so much trouble, have you? That is so interesting. Okay. So we know that the turn one Sylveon is super annoying, so we're gonna have to play to that. Yeah. We're gonna battle again with the same rules, and let's go into game two. Okay. Alright, that Chargeabog is turning out to be a lot more annoying than I would like. Right, of course. We're gonna select the same team. And yeah. Na-na-na. Yeah, let's go. Okay. So if he starts again with the same stuff, that's gonna be annoying. We're gonna bring this time. Unfortunately, I don't have a clean way to one-shot the Chargeabog, but we can resist certain hits, so I guess I'm gonna start with this. See what happens. In the back, I'm always gonna have the Flutter Mane, and I still think that this Pokemon is gonna be annoying for him. He doesn't really have a way to set up a Tailwind, so that's fine. Alright, let's hope that this works out. Sylveon, definitely put a lot of work in the first turn. I did not respect that Chargeabog, and is really messing me up. So, nice. So we know that the Chargeabog has String Shot, it has Struggle Ball, and it has, I guess, Pounce. So it will be smart trying to get rid of it as soon as possible, but that is easier said than done, I guess. It's a Terra Water Chargeabog. Okay, so he's gonna go with this strategy now. Alright, I respect it. Yeah, that is fine. I mean, we always just call mine with this, right? And we're gonna go ahead and explore into which one is gonna be more annoying. I think the Sableye is gonna be more annoying, so we're gonna go for the Sableye. Hopefully they are not safety goggles. Sableye start a fire. Good to know. Alright, I like how he switched it up. Just because it works for him, right? Ice Fan? Okay then. So you just activated my weakness policy, which is great. Right? His life orb. Good to know. Alright. There goes that. Uh-huh. We just spore the Sableye. Fantastic. Fantastic. Alright. Cool. So we know that the Barracuda is that. It's good to know. Good to know. So yeah, they gave us a weakness policy boost, which is fantastic. If we get rid of you, that would be great. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna Rage Powder and just Aeroblast into the thing. See what happens? They made Terra. That's fine with me. I gotta remember I cannot put two of his Pokemon to sleep at the same time. Alright, he did try to go for a priority move, which is good for me. Just gonna Rage Powder. See what they are trying to do. They're trying to go for Liquidation. Fantastic. That's not gonna do anything to Baldi. And he's gonna take some damage as well. Catch the Aeroblast. Let's go. Okay, Sableye is gone. That's good. Let's see what they send out now. It doesn't seem that anything they say now is gonna make him faster, so I think we're good in this area. Yeah, he shouldn't have any priority, so he could send out the Chargabot. That will be fine. Yeah. So he sends out the Chargabot, which is annoying. I'm just gonna go for a Psyshock into you and a Humble Spore into this, so you're not annoying anymore. He's gonna go for the Iceman. Baldi takes it. Illusion Hell, that's fine. Psyshock should take you out, and he does. Right? Alright, there goes Harpoon. There goes Harpoon. And Baldi just gets the Spore off. Fantastic. Alright. Uh-huh. Okay, so Sappy is not going to be bothering for a little bit. He goes into Ribbons, which is the Sylveon. We do not care much for it, I guess. But really, it doesn't. It's not really doing much damage of anything. Yeah. We just go for the Psyshock on it, right? Psyshock on it, and the only punish will be if he wakes up with the thing. So actually, I'm gonna go for the Aeroblast into this, and I'm gonna go for the Spore. No, actually, I cannot do that. I'm just gonna go for a Seed Bomb. See how fast you are. All right, so they are not gonna protect the Sylveon. Which is interesting. Oh, we get a critical hit. Oof. I'm sorry, mate. But now I could have gone for the Spore, I guess. I am faster than the Sylveon. That is fantastic to know for next battle. Because we're definitely going to a next battle. Hyper Voice. Oh my god, that does nothing to Lugia. Yeah. I predict that the next game he is definitely going to bring Urshifu. Right. What do I want to show him? I want to show him Fluttermane. Because I don't want to show him that I did bring Song. Okay. Let's finish it off, I guess. Psyshock and your Shadow Ball, right? Yeah. Okay, that's going to be game two. Should take you out. It does. Fantastic. Okay. So we're 1-1, which is good for us. We managed to tie the score, but now we got to face probably the same team that we faced first for turn one, which is going to be annoying. So yeah, we're going to battle again with the same rules, and they're probably gonna go back to strategy number one, or at least if I'm Deng, I definitely lead with Sylveon and the Battery Man first. I'm probably just gonna go with my own, with what I did game two, because realistically there's no reason to do anything else. Although admittedly, no, Pounce is annoying because I can steal over my speed. So yeah, let's go with that. And let's see what happens. And good luck, have fun to Dandy. This game is for all the marbles. Here we go. I'm fully expecting to see Krillin and Daddy. Okay. So is he gonna fake out my Lugia? If he fakes out my Lugia and then he goes for the Wicked Blow, that would be super bad. So I'm gonna go to Agias in there, and I'm just gonna try to put that dang thing to sleep. Yeah. Alright. Come back, Lugia. No need to risk you here. We just go to Koridon, which is pretty decent here. As Rosins increases the Urshifu's thing, the thing, right? They're gonna protect the daddy. Let's go. Okay, that's good. That's actually pretty freaking good. Let's see if they went for the priority. I don't know what they went for, but whatever it was, it didn't work out for them, I guess. Okay, cool. What do we want to do? Yeah, the Urshifu is really annoying, but he's Terra whatever. Urshifu doesn't letter. Let me see. Urshifu doesn't letter any pheromones, right? Do you letter any pheromones, good sir? Play rough? Pheromones. Okay, he doesn't learn any pheromones. Okay. I'm just gonna go ahead and try to get rid of the Sableye to annoying shenanigans going on. Next game. And so I can put stuff to sleep again. Oh damn, they are the berry. Yeah, they're probably gonna leave this hit then. He ice punches. Oh my god, that does so much damage. Okay, that's fine. He's definitely going to probably ice punch again, I will guess. Yeah, an ice punch is actually really annoying. But I think they're gonna protect. They should protect. Let's see if I call you bluff. Oh, they're actually in a Terra. Why are you doing this to me, Valdi? I should have just put it to sleep. Man. The mind games. This thing must be like Sash or something. Alright, the creature is still asleep, which is good for me. Which means I at least get to take it out, and I can bring Flutter my next turn, I guess. Oh, I actually live. That's great. I reduce my defenses for nothing. For nothing, man. Alright, but the Sableye I've been dead is fantastic. Yeah. Okay. Oh shoot, the ribbons. Okay. I mean, we have seen already that you don't want to take the Heavy Slam. So we're going to go for the Heavy Slam. Do we want to go for the Heavy Slam? Yeah, we do want to go for the Heavy Slam. We're going to go for the Heavy Slam. If he kills me with that, I just sport it. But if this thing is safety goggles, I might as well know now, right? Or I could just... I gain nothing if he safety goggles though. Five spore, that's pretty good. Man, what do I wanna do? I do wanna try to go for the spore. Alright, let's see what happens. Yeah, he protects the ribbons. Absolute sense. If his safety goggles, this is gonna hurt me. Yeah, he protects it. I mean, my Agias is definitely gonna die here. Man. That is unfortunate. That is very unfortunate. Are you safety goggles? You are not safety goggles, sir. That is fantastic. Okay. So we 100% go into this. Alright. I could kill you, or I could call mine first. Actually, I think I'm gonna call mine first. There's no reason to risk my Flurrymane. I call mine, he Hyper Voice, he takes out my Baldi, but then I have a Flurrymane with maybe one turn at Sun. Yeah, I think that's what I'm gonna have to do. Oh, okay, he withdraws that, which is great. Oh, okay. No, that's fine. That's absolutely fine. Yeah. Putting the damage on Sylveon is gonna be great. Oh, that is almost a two shot. Alright, takes out Baldi. That's fine. Baldi did plenty of work, which is great. Right, they get a boost onto everything, which is good for them. Sunlight Phase, which is annoying, but Flurrymane can help. Okay. So, I think we definitely want to go for the Chargabog here. Because I think he's going to try to protect the Sylveon. But if we take out the Chargabog, then we're going to be in a very, very good position. So the Aeroblast does hit. Oh my god. How is that so bulky? Oh my god. Strange shot. Yeah, okay, that's very rough. Okay. So, I think I definitely want to... Alright, I definitely want to Psyshock here. And use Shadow Ball, right? Because it might be faster than me. I don't think it is faster than me, though. Alright, we're gonna do this. That's fine. Oh, I am faster. Oh, that's fantastic. And we take it out. Let's go! Let's go for you putting no speed on your Pokemon. Okay, that is pretty good. Alright, we know the Urshifu has Protect. It may have Poison Jab. Alright, so we know that we are faster than the Chargabog, and we have the Sash intact on the thing still. So I think we are looking pretty decent. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and Terra Fairy and just Psyshock into this, and Shadow Ball should kill this. Just so he cannot Wicked Blow, critical hit me if he wakes up. Although I'm pretty sure he still has one turn of guaranteed sleep. Alright, let's go XD001. Yeah, they're faster than everybody because of the thing, but alright. Chargabog is dead. Thank god, man, that Pokemon is so annoying. And this should take you out. It's a plus one super effective hit. Oh my god. Wow. Okay. I'm just gonna Aeroblast Dazzling Shadow Ball, I guess. They do wake up. Good for them. They do have Wicked Blow, that... Yeah. Yeah, there's the Sash. Unfortunately for you. And I believe Shadow Wolf will take you out. Alright, 2-1. GG's to Voldy, man. He really brought the fight. I definitely question not bringing Terrapagos. But the sets that he brought actually were pretty good. The Terra Poisons were pretty clutch, man. I did not expect those. I should have just brought a Terra attack on Koridon. But I thought that between fighting and steel, it would be good. And it is good coverage. His Urshifu was a little bit too heavy for Heavy Slam to do anything to it. So, okay, we're gonna take the Big One victory, which is fantastic. Thank you, Baldi, for the battle. Thank you, everybody, for watching. And yeah, we'll see you on the next battle. Bye now.